good to have them both on the show, Van Morrison and Cliff Richard. Now, my final guest's career as a granite-jawed character actor took a complete 90-degree turn a few years ago when he displayed a brilliant deadpan comic talent in Airplane. He followed that with the biggest comedy film hit of the year, the hilarious cop spoof Naked Gun. And that was based on television's Police Squad. Let's see a bit of that now.
Where were you when all this happened?
I was right here at my desk working.
And when was the first time you noticed something was wrong?
Well, when I first heard the shot, and as I turned, Jim fell.
Yeah, he's the teller, Frank.
But Jim fell's the teller?
No, Jim Johnson.
Who's Jim fell?
Well, he's the auditor, Frank.
He had the flu, so Jim filled in.
Phil who?
Phil did, and he's the night watchman.
If only Phil had been here.
All right, now, wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Twice came in and shot the teller and Jim fell.
No, he only shot the teller, Jim Johnson. Fell is ill.
Okay, then after he shot the teller, you shot twice.
No, I only shot once.
Twice is the holdup, man.
Then I guess I did shoot twice.
Well, so now you're changing your story.
He made a big noise on this show the last time. Leslie Nielsen. Welcome back.
I saw you snickering there.
I was doing
that's your kind of humor.
I was doing a bit of snickering.
Yes, I think so.
I love that kind of thing. I mean, who doesn't?
I give up. Is that a riddle?
Don't start now. Look, please. Okay, you can behave like that in American talk shows, yes. But not here. Please, you're supposed to answer the questions.
I will be here.
I'll put that again. Who doesn't?
Who doesn't? Where is he?
He's not in tonight.
He's on second.
Yes,
he's on first.
He's with Phil Dean.
Now, look, let me ask you a question.
Yes, quite right.
You might can think of one. That show, Police Squad, The Naked Gun, was based on that.
That's true. Now, The Naked Gun is from the files of Police Squad.
And why was Police Squad not the kind of success that it should have been?
We thought it was going to be one of the biggest hits of the season. And we realized, after it had been on for about 4 weeks, it was pulled off in America because the ratings were not high. They got worse and worse. It's the kind of humor that doesn't belong on television, on the small screen, because you had to watch it. Thermopolis, who was the head of programming at ABC, said it didn't make it because you had to watch it. What he meant was you had to pay attention to it. It's the kind of humor you have to pay attention to.
Yeah.
And we don't really watch or pay attention to television in America. Your viewing habits here are much more disciplined than in America, because here with the BBC and so on, if you tune in to watch a show, it's because you want to watch that show. You don't have it as an accompaniment in the background.
Oh,
so it didn't
so
make
sure.
It. The screen was too small.
I'm not so sure about this.
Really? Is he right or wrong?
Half the audience has gone asleep already.
You can tell me. I'm a doctor. don't tell me, man. It's okay.
But everybody does love those spoof cop shows, those bad cops. I mean, how do the cops themselves?
Judge was just trying to keep up with my friends, and they had gone ahead through the light. And she says, and she looks over at her partner, she says, "It's Leslie Nielsen." She says, "You just used bad judgment?" I said, "Yeah." She says, "You won't do it again?" I says, "No." She says, "Okay, this is a warning." But I'm positive. The only reason that they let me go is because of Naked Gun and Police Squad. Well, it must be reassuring to them to know that there is a civilian, myself, out there in the wide open spaces who understands what police work is really like.
We do have just the merest vignette from Naked Gun.
That happened in my fourth marriage.
Boy finds girl, boy loses girl, girl finds boy. Boy forgets girl, boy remembers girl. Girl dies in a tragic blimp accident over the Orange Bowl on New Year's Day.
Good year?
No, the worst.
Oh, dear. Funny face.
Thank you.
laughter at that?
I can't see the picture without laughing. It breaks me up. Maybe a modest or whatever, but I just love the laughter of that.
But your great genius is, if I may be a sycophant, is that you're so deadpan. I mean, surely when you're doing a scene like that, it's impossible.
Don't call me Shirley.
Well, go on. Do the line.
Yes, don't call me Shirley.
There you go. We didn't rehearse that either. Yeah. So anyway, you must break up when you're doing that kind of. How long does it take to shoot a scene like that?
Most of the time, we're going straight through, but there are times when I broke up in the banquet sequence where I tell Priscilla off and I say, it's too bad. You know, we could have been something. And I reached out, we were rehearsing, and I reach out and I tickle hold of her cheek. Well, I was supposed to just go, you know, like this, but I reached out and I went. So David came over. I said, watch this. He says, that's good, put it in. So the moment I did it in the actual shooting, I reach out. Priscilla's gone, I'm gone.
Wouldn't you like to, I asked our other two friends about it, wouldn't you like to have been a romantic lead?
Well, it's very tough to be a romantic lead and have a five-finger bow. My bow legs. It was a shattering thing for me to realize that I was bow-legged when I was a kid because I'd always wanted to be Tarzan's son. You can't do that, I realize. Can you imagine to have that ruled out, the horizon limited?
Is it bad?
I beg your pardon?
Are the legs?
Well, yes, it's quite bad. I mean, if you stop and take a look now. Yeah. Five fingers.
It's a five-finger bow, isn't it? It is a five-finger bow.
It certainly is.
Yeah.
Would I lie to you?
No.
No, not you, Terry.
You didn't have any physical disabilities that stopped you?
No, I'm total perfection.
You are, yeah. Yeah.
Perfection itself.
Itself.
It's to do with looks.
Are we having a look?
being a juvenile lead is to do with looks. You had the looks.
Well, I don't know
you
what
have
happened.
You have the looks.
I should hope so.
Yeah.
I never really even, I did a few westerns. I never even got a chance to kiss the horse. But what a, you know, to do a love sequence, a love scene with Priscilla Presley, I mean.
Yes, it's okay.
She is extraordinary, exquisite.
Doing love scenes, are they embarrassing?
Well, to whom?
No, they're certainly embarrassing to the viewer, but are they embarrassing to you while you're doing them?
No, not at all. I mean, after all, I'm a professional. I mean, we're all. We're
and you're a married man.
Well, no, I'm not, but that makes no difference.
Do you know, I wondered why we hadn't had you on this program before. But you've managed to remain unspoiled and unchanged by celebrity, haven't you?
Yeah,
how do you handle that in Hollywood?
To be unspoiled?
Yeah.
Insensitivity. Well, it helps, Terry.
I can believe that.
It helps with my golf, I'll tell you.
Your golf is terrible, isn't it?
Well, it used to be. It's improved slightly.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you got thrown off pro-celebrity golf on the BBC because you took 32 on the first hole. I remember.
I didn't take anything on the first hole. I didn't even get off the tee. Don't go through that experience.
No,
it was too terrible.
Too terrible for
you. Oh, dear me.
Hollywood, you've been there. Would you like to settle down and be a big star in Hollywood, Joss?
I don't think I could ever really settle down there, no. It's fascinating for a time. I loved doing a movie there. But, the trouble is I found it a very isolated place. Don't you agree?
The 100%. That is the key word.
I don't think they've heard of China, you know, in Hollywood. And when they go.
Well, they've heard of porcelain.
But you know,
some kind of pottery from Mexico, anyway.
But there is no real connection with the rest of the world, is there? It's a world of its own.
Well, that's why somebody like this comes over here and really is confused.
I certainly am.
He is. But nonetheless, we're glad you came.
I'm delighted.
And we're looking
to be
forward.
Here.
We're looking forward to part the second of the Naked Gun.
That's right. We begin in March.
Good for you, Leslie.
Vanilla,
thank you.
Thank you,
Joss. Pleasure. And thank you. And as the dust begins to settle on this old emporium, we'll bid you a fond farewell, hoping to find you in the same place, the same spot on the old dial, in the full of your health, at 7 o'clock on Monday. Have a weekend. Good night. Thank you.